Hello again, everyone. Welcome back to Suikoden 5. All right, let's go ahead and have Aldhead right inside and make an attack. Let's see. You can recover on Zarase.
Rebel army's attacking! Damn! Barum, Dilver, you worthless fools! Fortify the gate! Don't let the rebels come in! Kill them all!
Sir, civilians have swarmed our gate garrison! There's a struggle underway there right now!
What?!
Damn those Queen's Knights! Damn that stupid Godwin! Nobody tells us what we can and or can't do!
Oh, Prince, those animals killed my son! Avenge his death, I beg you!
Open the gate! Let the prince in! We can't hold the civilians back! The gate's gonna break!
Ah! Damn them! Damn them all! All troops back to the castle now!
Their gate defenses have weakened. Now, Your Highness, storm the gate!
Only a victory! I guess it's a time-based thing. Crap! Oh, come on. Alright, you know what? I'm going to break the video here, and I'm going to redo that. I'm going to try to do it a lot faster, killing just the specific units that I need to get the items, and see if that'll get me the victory plus. So, I'll be right back. Alright, let's try this again, see if we can actually get our victory plus out of this. Just let Ald get into the bridge. I think maybe just being faster at attacking might be the key. I didn't spend as much time waiting. There we go. Okay, yeah, it was time. It was a time issue. That's really what it boiled down to. All right. Well, I got a windspun cape. I got all the other items. I thought I took care of you guys' units.
I swear! Death! Death to them all! You!
Yes, sir!
If the rebel army gets in, set the town ablaze!
But...
Those rebels and worthless townspeople, I'm gonna kill every last one of them.
That's enough, you incompetent fool!
How dare you!
We've lost the people's trust because of your wretched antics. No wonder we've been backed against the wall like this. Don't you understand?
You disappoint me, Barum. Are you saying that I'm wrong and the rebel army is right?
Now hold on, I never meant...
Now that I think of it, you once served under that old hag, Raja, didn't you? Of course. Now I get it. Our naval leader was secretly conspiring with the rebel army. What? That's why we keep losing all these battles. There is a traitor in our midst.
How dare you call me a traitor? Kildrick, stop this nonsense this minute.
If it's such nonsense, then why doesn't the traitor prove his innocence?
Fine, if that's what it takes, I will. Barum. No, it's okay. Dilver, take over here. But...
Getting overlapping music there, game.
The prince!
The prince has come! We're saved!
The prince! The prince!
Yeah, you know, guys, do you remember last time I was here and you were all snobby and stuff like that? You want to take some of that back at this point? Shan?
The battle's not over just yet. Tell the people that they must wait in their homes until it's completely safe.
Oh, I suppose I should mention what I kind of did in that battle. So basically, I sent the Dragon Cavalry and the Ram up against the ship with the Flowing Rune. And I moved everyone else down with them. And then just kind of, you know, sent them up against the specific things as they got close. While my land units went first after the archer with the barrage, and then the archer with the rage. And then we just kind of, you know, at that point it was just a lot of mopping up it, really. Everyone else had gotten involved, and it was just kind of making sure that nothing, none of their units that were strong against one of ours could get within, you know, could attack the right person. So that's basically what it was.
Understood, my lady. Kildrick's main forces fled into the castle.
They're gonna use the wharf in the back to escape again.
Need a hand, Prince? Come on, let's go.
Please choose who will accompany you, Your Highness.
Do I have to take Rogue? I have to take Rogue, and I have to take Lance. Well, alright, well, let's take Miakis along. Miakis is always good. And, you know, maybe Jean and Zarase. I think that might be a good team. Of course I'm demanding your presence, Zarase. Alright, we'll get Babbage in. Get Egbert in, because I imagine we're going to have random encounters. Let's go with Marina. And Maraud. There we go.
Are you happy with these members, Your Highness?
Well, I'd rather not take Rogue and Lance along.
The enemy is cornered now. They will be desperate. Please proceed with extreme caution.
I'm not sure if he'll actually be riding Lance. I don't remember enough about the dragon rides. Seriously? Why can't I have Miakis following me?
Brits, let's take this bull by the horns!
Seriously, Miakis, what do you see in him? Alright, formation-wise. Not this one. Let's see, we've got a 3 short range. This one might, nah. Don't really want to go with that one. There really aren't many things that'll put 3 short-range people in the front. What a crap. Other than this one, so I guess we'll go with this one. Yep, that'll be fine. Let's see. Look at all of the spell points that Jean and Zarase have. Jean actually has one more on the third level than Zarase does. I'm actually kind of impressed by that. Let's see. What else do I want? I don't think... Oh, you actually do have skills. Dragon special. Cluster attack percent for Dragon Horse plus. Oh. Okay, well, kind of wish that I'd thought about that and built those up, but oh well. It'll be fine. I'm sure it'll be fine. You see, Rook should totally be riding on Lance, and that would be a thing in Suikoden 3. That would have been awesome. We got elite soldiers. Let's see, form skill is just attack first. I hate that one. Well, I suppose we'll use it. Might as well. Maybe I should have taken Galleon along. Jeez, nice going. All water orb and a night orb. Got some levels for Lance. I suppose a good thing about the dragons is that they don't. The dragon horses is that they don't have Scarlet Charge. Okay. Yeah, they don't have weapons that need sharpening. So, wow, E in almost everything. Jeez, it's pretty horrible. Let me take a quick look to see if there's anything around town. Yeah, don't really have much to worry about. No items. Is that a... Yeah, it's a column of enemies. That's pretty crap. What rune do you have again? You've got a Rage Sword rune. Don't care. Let's see. Energy damage divided amongst all enemies. Damage to all enemies. Go with some magic. I will definitely be doing Flame Array in the boss battle, though. I love how the effect of that goes underneath the sidewalk. Nice damage. Ow, stop that. Alright, that might have been a little unnecessary at that point. Yeah, I'd agree with not bad. That's an accurate assessment. How did you guys get here before us?
Your Highness, the castle's nearly empty. Most of the enemy troops are trying to escape with Luger's fleet. Raffly is on their way to intercept. Sounds good. Let's join him, Prince. Hop on, I'll take you to the Dahok.
Really? Well, I guess that explains why he's long. Well, what about Jean, Zarase, Miyakis? Are they also riding the Dragon Horse?
We must bring General Novum and the Queen's Knight Unit back to Lord Godwin. All ships, break through their blockade so we can escape. My ship will clear the way.
Will it now? Will it really? Oh, we are actually going to get different stuff out of this upcoming battle.
Barum. Don't let him get any closer. Use flaming arrows.
Why didn't we use these before? There are two rams there. Two combat ships.
It's not over yet.
Don't let them through. Stop them with the side of the ship.
Admiral.
You can do it, can't you?
Of course.
It's just kind of nice to see the,
Ha-ha!
Ah!
Quick, they're stuck! Now's our chance!
Parum, forgive me. Raja, she's unsinkable.
So she's Molly Brown?
She leaves me no choice.
No choice. Hey, that's my ship.
Admiral.
So Bahamut wants some hand-to-hand, does he?
Show yourself, Raja. It's your former student, Bahram Luger, leader of the Falanan Royal Navy. I've come for your head.
Hello!
What the?
I like how it didn't show us actually on the dragon horse.
Your Highness, I see you've taken after your father in my ways?
I think that's supposed to be many ways.
Gathering the support of the townspeople. It would seem that the people have rejected us in favor of your side. Nevertheless, we must think of the future, even if the people themselves are against us.
Not quite sure you understand this whole politics thing, Bahram.
We must preserve our right to power and maintain order so that Falanum may continue to prosper.
Preserve your right to power.
I believe with all my heart that Lord Godwin is the one who will make that happen. He alone will save Falana.
Except he's getting his butt royally kicked. He made an alliance with our long-term enemy. Maybe not. Just saying.
For Lord Godwin!
Well. Okay. Let's see. Cooperative attack. Scarlet Charge. Let's target Bahram. Let's see. Let's do Battlefield. In the off chance that goes off first. Don't think it will. First Ray on Bahram. And Thunder Rune. Thunderstorm. Unite Magic. Flame Array. 1600 damage to all enemies. Let's do it. Oh, yeah. Goes off first. Ow! You bypassed the dragon horse. That's rude. Have some of that. Wow. Dragon horse's defense is pretty awesome. Should totally put a Firefly rune on the dragon horse. It's pretty good boss music, though. Damn! Nice! Now he gets on it. Wait, seriously? Was that all the damage it did? Oh, that's not even all that much. Rage Sword, let's see. It's better to attack. Actually, cooperative attack. Sworn Protector. Alright, Rune. Thunderstorm. And no, not the Rage. Let's do a Meteor Shower. This might kill him. Nope. This might kill him. Dropping a giant rock on his head. Nope. Wow, that was not very much damage. What are you doing? Oh! Ow! Here, have some lightning. Yeah, I'd laugh a little bit like that, too. All right, so we got, I think we got about the same amount of money. We got less party SP out of that. But we got a Shredding Scroll. We got a Resurrection Piece and a Berserk Blow Scroll. The Resurrection Piece, though, much better than a Mother Earth Piece, in my opinion. Not that I've really figured out who to give that to, but...
Very impressive, Your Highness.
Yeah, I thought so.
You may look impressive, but you're just as inept as ever I see.
Master.
The other ships have all gotten away. Are you happy now?
I suppose I am.
I don't remember teaching you to fight so brazenly.
I couldn't hope to surpass you if I only used what you taught
me. Well, don't think you've surpassed me with this folly of yours.
You're as harsh as ever. I'm sorry for failing you as a student.
A student isn't supposed to die before a master, you fool.
You could always kill yourself.
That's the worst sin a student can commit.
She's not a cat. You don't need to pet her, Ald. And he did actually die. I don't think Jadan Gisu dies. I think he might go into the jail, which is actually something, part of the castle that I missed checking on earlier. So I'm going to have to run down there. There's not a whole lot there, but there is an interesting little room.
Kildrick and General Novum have fled to Stormfist, Your Royal Highness.
And I'm happy to say we've achieved our initial goal.
Didn't I have taken back Sable? You should have seen it!
We also pushed the Armist Southern Mountain Corps all the way across the border and killed Jidan Gisu.
Oh, well, maybe he did die in the other path. I don't know.
Good work, both of you.
Do we ever capture anyone?
At last, we finally recaptured the lands we held before Armus invaded.
Yes, but I can't believe all the trouble we went through just to get back to where we were before.
No, you humans really know how to get things done.
That's right, you guys aren't bad for humans. I hate to say it, but I was sure we were goners there for a while. But you humans gave them what's for.
This must be a humiliating turn of events for Godwin. He even tried to save his cause by allying with Armus, a nation he despises. Yet still he failed. I doubt he has anything else up his sleeve, but he's not one to surrender peacefully.
I agree. If he had wanted to surrender, he would have done so before dragging Armus into the war.
You make a most wise observation, Lady Mercus.
In fact, I don't think his alliance with Armus was intended to be a winning strategy. Most likely it was just a bid to buy time, to prepare for his next move.
And here's the scene that we actually ended it previously.
Your commandership, please forgive me. Because of my failure, the Western Marine Corps has...
Oh, Alenia, you need not blame yourself for what happened.
We should consider ourselves lucky that the eminent Shula Valya went home without even lifting a finger. But your commandership...
Armus has fulfilled his purpose. We only needed them as a distraction while we laid down the foundations for the next step in our plan.
And what exactly is your plan?
Having doubts, are we? We're only doing what must be done for Felaena. Under our control, Felaena shall become the most revered nation in the world. United, pure, perfect!
No nation is perfect. Well, Lady Sealeeds, would you like to back out now? Why are you asking me that? Oh, no reason. Perhaps you would be so kind as to do me a favor? Depends on the favor.
Don't trust a guy who smiles like that.
So, what is it?
You're free to decline, but somehow I don't think you'll turn me down. You're not going to tell me, the player, or us, the viewers, what that is, huh? Alright, well, let's go visit that room that I missed earlier. It's just us and the party right now. This is a point where, if you had chosen to stay in the castle rather than leave, things would be back to where they were before. Let's check the, suggestion box. New arrivals. Kildrick from Richard.
Is he the guy who won the Sacred Games? Well, he's not Mueller, so see if I care about him.
Yumino from Lou. Oh, and it has a little poorly drawn cat with a heart on it.
Come on, you said you wanted to be all talk alone on the roof, but you skipped out. Yumino!
What? What are you talking about, Lou? Mining carts from Sorensen.
Everybody always talks about how great they are, so I went to see for myself. They were even better than I imagined. I'll bet if Wabun and the professor worked together, they could make something even better. That is, if they could manage to play nice. Oops.
Elves from Wabun.
They say the elves and dwarves are really going at each other up in the northern continent. But don't worry, we elves here in Felena never even think about elves.
It's like elves? I think I meant dwarves. That's a reference to Suikoden 1. Raging Nostrum from Sigiri.
That drug loses its power quickly, so you can't make a lot of it in advance. So the stuff they're using can't be from the old organization. They have to be making new batches. They know how to make it, so that means they'll use it again. I'd be careful if I were you.
Untitled from Babbage. The comment box is full of blueprints for mechanical devices. None of them have explanations. Armor from Isabel.
Is my armor really all that strange? It's just easy to move in, that's all. It leaves your inner thighs completely uncovered.
I'll have to get her in. I mean, when I do the combo episode, look at her legs. It's like terribly impractical.
People ask if it even protects me, but the truth is that Matthias is all the armor I need.
Oh, hi. Norma and her leopard from Chisato.
I had no idea I'd run into them here. What a pleasant surprise.
And that's about it.
Both Stormfist and Solfalena are finally within our grasp. Should we crush Stormfist first, or concentrate on Solfalena? Both choices have good points and bad points.
I suppose they do. Alright, let's see. First of all, let me check a few things. There is one more person that we can recruit coming up. Oh. He has the haggle ability. I was wondering if that was in the game. Damn, you get it late. Anyway, we'll probably start off the next episode with that. I don't think there's much else to do. We've got a statue room. Oh, hey, it actually changed. All right, let's see. A statue of Cornelio in honor of the greatest healer. A statue of Zarase in honor of the most damage inflicted. This used to be Leon. We haven't used her in a really long time, and she was there. Only now is Zarase, surpassing her. And a statue of Leon in honor of the most enemies defeated. It's pretty impressive, actually. We've got a prison here. No one's in this cell. Actually, not sure if these cells get used. I can't recall.
Lord Rawbell is a good man who seems to have terrible luck. His town was sacked by bandits. Thieves came after him. Well, Your Highness captured the whole lot of them, thank goodness. Hopefully Lord Rawbell can rest easy now.
And this is a painted-on door. And there's nothing out that way. So that's just the things that we missed earlier. Let's see. Alrighty. Yep. I think that. Anyway, we actually, looks like we'll have some recruiting to do in the next episode, which I think might get us up to about where we need to be. So, I might actually spend the next episode going to get one of the optional characters who I have not gotten yet. If for some reason I can't actually do that right now, like I had to do it earlier, I'll just go reload a save. But anyway, that's about it for this episode. In the next one, we're going to be doing probably the last real round of recruiting in the game. Because we're pretty much at our... we're just about at the maximum number of people. Let's head up here. Let's take a quick look at the Tablet of Stars. Anything new to say now?
Maybe Lord Godwin's little scholars are having some success.
Hmm. Well, that's a reference to. So Lord Godwin is interested... Oh, it's the same thing. What do you have to say?
I had a quick look, but they don't appear to have touched the core of the ruins. Maybe they were given strict orders not to touch anything until Lord Godwin's survey team came.
Alright, let's see. We're missing one, two, three, four, five, six. We're missing six stars. That's it. We've got 102 stars on our tablet. And if we go back and talk to... Actually, we'll do that on screen. If we go back and talk to... Aboro, I believe there's only two left who are in the... research to figure out how to recruit them list thingy. Oh, yeah, and I also have him doing some research on Lucretia.
Lord Godwin originally found her on a trip to the northern continent and came back with her. At first, people called her his mistress, but after all she did during the Armus invasion, no one ever bowed-mouthed her again.
All right, so let's see. So we've got Haleth here. Whereabouts? We've got Shun. Whereabouts? And that's about it. So there's two listed there. So that would take us up to 104. And the rest are, well, I guess they're kind of story. I'm not sure if they are actually story or not. I'll need to double check. Anyway, let me go trigger off the next background search. And we'll call this an episode. In the next one, like I said, we'll do some more recruiting. See you then, everyone.